The People's Front for Freedom, PFF, led by Erias Lukwago, has launched a nationwide signature collection campaign aimed at formalizing its registration as a political party. The launch at the Katonga Road offices in Kampala saw Kampala Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago, the interim president of the FDC Katonga faction, outline the campaign's objectives and expectations. Lukwago emphasized that the exercise is legally sanctioned, with the PFF having secured clearance from the Electoral Commission.
This mighty party in the pipeline, duly registered. You are aware we assigned this duty at this very, very place on the 19th day of August. We had a delegates conference that sat here. Amongst the resolutions that were made, is to have the FDC dissolved within a period of 6 months. I must assure you that exercise is already underway.
The initiative follows a resolution during the FDC delegates conference where members agreed to form a new political entity. Lukwago clarified that the PFF's mission is to collaborate with other groups to advance national liberation, not to compete within the political space.
Let us not be hostile and confrontational against our colleagues in the struggle, because this is not all about competition. We are not competing with anyone, and we are not registering this particular platform merely to participate in elections. No. It's not about participation in elections.
The Electoral Commission recently approved the registration of the PFF following persistent efforts by the Katonga faction, a breakaway group from the Forum for Democratic Change, FDC. With the green light from EC, PFF can now collect signatures to formalize its registration. The group is required to collect 50 signatures from at least 97 districts in Uganda. The signatures will undergo a stringent verification process to ensure authenticity and prevent forgery. The Committee of Parliament on Agriculture, Animal Industries and Fisheries today scrutinized the proposed amendments on the merger of some government ministries and parastatals, among which are Uganda Coffee Development Authority, UCDA, Dairy Development Authority, DDA, NADS and Cotton Development Authority. The committee, which was presided over by Deputy Chairperson Hope Grania Nakazibwe, was however appalled by the fact that the Minister for Agriculture made no appearance during the meeting and neither signed the proposed bill. This angered the committee, which resolved not to process the proposals until the minister appears before the committee to answer pending questions about the proposed amendments.
We do not have a memorandum that is signed, as we have all seen, and it seems to be hard to get the officials from Ministry of Agriculture to have them signed for us to proceed today.
This issue of signing is not it's not the speaker imposing it on us.
I know it is the by rules. Procedures.
Yeah, it's the rules. So if we are to follow the right process of proceeding with these bills, actually, it should be. The bills must be signed.
The legislators also expressed fear that dissolution of UCDA could most likely affect the quality of coffee because the minister cannot monitor farmers effectively, as has been with the case. The mayor of a city in southern Mexico has been murdered less than a week after taking office, according to authorities yesterday, the latest in a series of attacks on politicians in violence-plagued Latin American country. The killing of Chilpancingo Mayor Alejandro Arcos fills us with indignation, Guerrero State Governor Evelyn Salgado wrote on social media, without providing further details of the circumstances. Arcos was elected in June, representing an opposition coalition that included the Institutional Revolutionary Party, PRI, which denounced his killing as a cowardly crime and called for justice.